talking about in lesson 210. You already have these notes, but let's go through and make sure that you have a good understanding of what we're doing here, okay? This is solving inequalities using multiplication and division, okay? And the one thing you have to watch for is whether or not the coefficient, that's the number that's next to the variable, is negative. If it is negative, after you solve it, you must reverse the sign in order to make the solution true, right? So the first thing is to identify the coefficient when you're given an equation. Look at this first one. This was negative 7m is greater than 35. Is the coefficient negative? Yeah, negative 7 is the coefficient. So at the end, we have to reverse the sign from greater than, from m is greater than to m is less than. Now, to solve it, this is a multiplication equation. You can use division. Divide both sides by the reciprocal of the coefficient, or divide by negative 7 on both sides. Cross out the negative 7s and solve this one, 35 divided by negative 7, that's negative 5. So m is less than negative 5. To graph this, we would draw a number line. Mark negative 5 with an open dot and shade to the left. M is less than negative 5. So shade to the left. Okay? Look at this example again. The coefficient in this one is negative 1/6. It says negative m over 6 is less than 12. The coefficient then is negative 1 over 6. And we multiply by negative 6 over 1. The reciprocal of negative 1 over 6. Then, since we're multiplying by negative, we have to reverse the sign. So instead of less than, it's now greater than. And 12 times negative 6 is negative 72. And then this example, this one has a positive coefficient. It's 1m over 3, positive 1m over 3. And when you solve this, you have to multiply by the reciprocal 3 over 1. Since you're multiplying by a positive 3 over 1, you do not have to reverse the sign on this one. Okay? Let's go through a couple of problems that you did for today. Number 2. Negative 2x is less than 14. Okay, what's the coefficient, class?
2.
Negative 2.
Negative 2. So, are we going to reverse the sign at the end?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. This is a negative 2. We have to divide by a negative, and we have to reverse the sign. Okay? Now, the easiest way is to figure that out right away when you're starting the problem. I'm going to have to reverse the sign. Okay? So, when you start, if you want to draw this line, you could draw the line, reverse the sign right away, and then solve it. Divide both sides by negative 2. So x is greater than negative 7. Okay, graph this. Mark 0, mark negative 7 with an open dot. The variable is written first, so that we're going to shade the same direction as this arrow. Okay. Got this one?
I didn't graph.
Okay, it says solve and graph.
On the board it didn't say graph. On the board in our classroom.
Okay, this is the board you got to go by. Number 4. Number 4 is 6m is greater than 24. What's the coefficient? Lydia?
Six.
Six, positive six, right? Do we need to reverse the sign? No.
Nope, it's gonna stay as a greater than sign.
To solve it, divide by six on both sides. Six over six is one. So M is greater than four. Right? Draw a number line. Mark zero. Mark four. The M is written first. Use an open dot because of this sign. And shade to the right. Okay. How about one where there is division? Let's look at this one. X over negative 6 is greater than 3. This is number 14. X over negative 6 is greater than 3. Okay. So number 14 in every book. What's the coefficient? Joy?
Negative 6.
Negative 6 over 1 or... This is 1x, 1 over negative 6, yep. The coefficient is negative. Are we going to have to switch the sign? Yes. So that we have to make that a less than sign. We have to multiply by the reciprocal. What's the reciprocal? What's the reciprocal? James? Yeah, negative 6 over 1. Negative 6 over 1. Okay? Now what do we do? Cross out the negative 6s. That leaves us 1x. And what do we do on the other side? Right. Multiply 3 by negative 6. That's what we multiply by over here is negative 6. Negative 6 over 1 is the same as negative 6. So we multiply by negative 6 on this side. X is less than what, class? Negative 18. Mark negative 18 on a number line. Good open dot, shade to the left. Okay. How about one more of these? Let's go with number 20. 20 is less than b over 6. Number 20. 20 is less than b over 6. What's the coefficient here? What is it? Cannot be part of the coefficient. How many b's are there? One. So the coefficient is 1/6. What's the reciprocal of that?
6 over 1.
That's what we multiply by. Do we need to reverse the sign?
Not yet.
No. Cross out the 6s. Multiply by 6 over here. What's 6 times 20? Good, 120 is less than b. How do we graph this?
Okay, first you put where the 0 is, and then to the right, because it's 120, it's not negative. You put 120, and open dot,
yep.
And it points to the left.
Right. Which way is this one written? This one is written as 120 is less than b, which means that what is b? B is greater than 120. We want to graph what b is. Okay? So b is greater than 120. Okay? Make sure you're careful with those where the number is written first. Okay? Make sure that you turn that around so you know what that means. Alright, those are some example problems for lesson 210. Make sure you study those for the test.